This video illustrates debugging over XCP in TRACE32. XCP is a universal measurement and calibration protocol standardized by the Association for Standardization of Automation and Measuring Systems, ASAM. The XCP protocol is primarily used for in-field measurement, that is, the acquisition of values of ECU internal variables, and calibration for the adjustment of internal variables. In fact, the XCP protocol family allows to control measurement and calibration tools of various vendors. The protocol supports different transport layers as TCP/IP. The XCP slave can be a separate tool or be embedded in the ECU. This can cause major challenges for debugging, either because the debug interface is already in use by the separate tool, or because the debug interface is not accessible because the ECU is deeply buried in a car. Some of the measurement and calibration tools implement extensions to the XCP protocol that allow debugging of the target CPU. TRACE32 is able to use these features. Instead of sending debugging commands directly to the target CPU via low-level debug protocol, as JTAG, all debugging commands are encoded into XCP commands by the TRACE32 XCP debug backend. The XCP commands are then sent over the host computer's TCP stack and a network cable to the third-party XCP slave. The third-party system translates the XCP commands back into a low-level debug protocol. Typical examples are DAP for Infineon, Tri-Core CPUs, and JTAG. XCP debugging in TRACE32 requires a TRACE32 front-end license, as well as a TRACE32 XCP back-end license. Both are licensed using an RLM license server. Debug over XCP using the TRACE32 debug front-end offers the same debug features as TRACE32 hardware-based debuggers. XCP debugging has, however, the following limitations. No off-chip trace is available. Moreover, debugging is slower compared to a system with a hardware-based debugger. In fact, operations as single-step or memory access take longer. Furthermore, the system has a higher reaction time. TRACE32 supports two protocol variants for debugging over XCP. Software debugging over XCP as specified in the ASAM MCD-1 standard, starting from version 1.5, as well as the ETAS proprietary protocol extension. In order to set up TRACE32 for debugging over XCP, the following lines need to be added to the configuration file. The license information has to be set up in the license block. If you are using TRACE32 Start under Windows, you can add an MCI server to your configuration. Then add an MCI server debugger. Additionally, the processor architecture needs to be selected. In this demo, I'm using a TRACE32 PowerView for Tri-Core version of January 2021. To configure XCP debugging, open the System Settings window from the menu CPU, System Settings, then press Config. First, we need to select XCP as a debug port. After this configuration, the XCP tab is added to the System.config window. We then need to set the IP address and port number of the XCP slave. Last thing to do is to set the correct CPU selection. For the Tri-Core, this can be detected using the Detect button. The described configuration steps can be also done in a practice script. Now we can connect to the target using mode up or attach. I will use a practice script to load an ELF file and open some windows. If you've already used TRACE32 PowerView, you won't really notice any difference when debugging over XCP. For more information about debugging over XCP, please refer to the TRACE32 documentation. Thank you for your attention.